Hello guys, a very good morning to all of you. Myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So before beginning this session, let me inform you all that you can download the PDF of this session on the Telegram group. So the Telegram group's link is in description. If you want the detailed PDF, then you can join that group and download the PDF from there. And if you want, you can also subscribe our channel and hit the bell notification, because this will help you in getting the updates about the new uploads that we make, as well as the live sessions that we take. So on that note, let's begin with the first question. Where is India's largest open air fernery located? So the right answer here is Ranikhet. So Almora district, Ranikhet is the place in Almora district in Uttarakhand where this India's largest open air fernery been opened. Now this largest open air fernery, so this looks like this. Okay, the fernery is this. Fern is basically a type of plant, so it is there. This is the fernery. It has been established by a person, and the name of that person is very important. So the name is Nilambar Kunetha. Okay, so Nilambar Kunetha is the person, is the expert in the field of ferns, and he has opened this open air fernery that has more than 120 species of ferns collected from different parts of India. For example, Western Ghat ferns are also there. Then you have ferns from Eastern and Western Himalayan regions. Okay, so in total 30 species of ferns are there in this fernery. Now don't get confused that here 120 different types of ferns are mentioned and here 30 species are mentioned, because in one species you can find different types of plant. Okay, so a plant can vary, the type can vary within the one species as well. So in total 30 species are there, but the types are 120. Okay, so that was all about the fernery. Now let's move on to the next question. Which of the following AI powered projects has been launched by the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways for reducing road accidents? I Raste, I Sadak, I Rahagir, I Parivahan, I Sanchalan. So this I stands for intelligence. Here, since AI powered project is this, and AI is involved in this project, therefore this I is added to the name of that project. So the name is I Raste. Now it is the acronym of the total name of the entire name. So the name of this project is Intelligent Solutions for Road Safety Through Technology and Engineering. So this is the complete full form of the project that has been launched by Ministry of Road and Transport to reduce the number of road accidents by 50% by the year 2025. So 50% by 2025 and zero accidents by 2030. Okay, so this is the goal, that by 2030 we aim to become zero accident country where no road accident is taking place. However, you should also be aware of this fact that India comes in the list of the countries that have a highest number of road accidents, and from that India aims to achieve this target, zero accidents by 2030. Okay, and in order to achieve that target, this project has been launched by Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. So do remember the targets. Sub target is to reduce the road accidents by 2025, and the entire major target is zero accidents by 2030. Now we have discussed the full form as well, Intelligent Solution for Road Safety Through Technology and Engineering. It is an AI powered project, and what is the use of AI, how will this project work, that we will be discussing in the next slide. But let's look at the developers of this project, the participants of this project. Okay, Intel, National Institute for Transparency, Access to Information and Personal Data Protection. So this is one institution. National Institution for Transparency, Access to Information and Personal Data Protection, which is acronymed as INAI, IIT, Triple IT Hyderabad, CSIR, Central Road Research Institute, Mahindra and Mahindra, and Nagpur Municipal Corporation, because this project has been launched in Nagpur at present on a pilot basis. Okay. So you have to remember the city as well, the name of the city in which this project has been launched on a pilot basis. Okay, so at present this project is in Nagpur only. Now let's have a look at how they are going to do this. Okay, this is just for your conceptual understanding. This has nothing to do with the question itself, because this cannot become a question in your phase 1 GA. Okay, but if you understand the entire mechanism, how this project will work, it will help you in memorizing the other facts as well. Okay, so the modus operandi is, first, the very first step, they will identify the areas in Nagpur. Remember, this has been launched in Nagpur only. So first, they will be identifying the areas and categorize them in three zones: white, gray, and black. Okay. So white zones will have the least number of accidents, gray zones will have medium number of accidents, and black zones will be those zones which have the highest number of accidents. Okay. And then a map will be prepared of all these zones by using the artificial intelligence. So here AI comes into play. Second step is identify the reasons for accident. Whether is it the road infrastructure, whether is it the street light, whether something else is there. So what is the exact reason for accidents in the different areas, particularly black zones? Then the vehicles belonging to Nagpur Municipal Corporation will be equipped with sensors, will be equipped with collision avoidance technology in order to reduce accidents. Also, sensors will be applied on the road network so that the entire assessment of the reasons for accidents can be made by different organizations involved in this project. So this is how this project is going to work and reduce accidents. I hope that you have understood it. Now let's move on to the next question. With which of the Red Sea country did India conduct a bilateral maritime exercise for the first time? So this is the first time that India conducted this exercise with one of the countries located around the Red Sea, one of the countries bordering the Red Sea. And let me tell you, all the countries mentioned in the options border Red Sea. So which country is it then? The right answer here is Sudan. So India and Sudanese navies have conducted the maritime exercise in Red Sea off the Sudanese coast. INS Tabar and two Sudanese navies were involved in this exercise. Okay. How many Indian institutes have featured in the QS World University Rankings Full-Time MBA Global 2022? Seven institutes were there from India. So QS is a British company and it has released this ranking that assesses only the institutes providing MBA course. So how many institutes are assessed in this ranking? Over 280. Parameters were these: employability, entrepreneurship and alumni outcomes, return on investment, thought leadership, class and faculty diversity. So these were the parameters. Now the top three institutions are Stanford Graduate School of Business, Harvard Business School, Penn Wharton. So these are the three top business institutions. From India, the top three are IIM Ahmedabad, IIM Bangalore, and IIM Calcutta. So in total, seven institutions from India featured in this list that includes or assesses more than 280 business schools across the world. And out of these seven institutions, the top three are IIM Ahmedabad, Bangalore and Calcutta. Okay, itna yaad rahega guys, aapko yaad rakhna hi padega, you have no option. Okay, who has been appointed as the acting chairperson of the National Company Law Appellate Tribunal. So it is a very simple question of appointment. Justice M. Venugopal. So he is the person. Which of the following organization has won the Raj Bhasha Kirti Puraskar 2020-2021? The right answer is Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited. Now guys, this Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited's Vishakhapatnam steel plant has won this award, to be more precise. But as you can see, that options does not have this Vishakhapatnam steel plant. Therefore, you will mark the Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited, because both sides, either ways, the answer is correct. If you mark this Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited, when you don't have this plant in the option, then also your answer is correct. And if you mark this, when you don't have this in the option, or both, वैसे दोनों को एक साथ ऑप्शन में देंगे ही नहीं, because it will be senseless, okay? So because this is the subsidiary or a part of this Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited, okay? So do remember, the organization that has got this award is Vishakhapatnam Steel Plant, which is a subsidiary of this Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited. So why have they been given this award? Because they promoted their official, they promoted Hindi as their official language. This award was given on Hindi Divas, which is celebrated on September 14. Do remember. Now, this undertaking is a part of, again, Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited. So this has also been given this award. So these two organizations have got the same award. Raj Bhasha Purotsahan, Raj Bhasha Kirti Puraskar, okay? In 2018-19, now this is not very important. This entire sentence is not important. Why did I put this sentence here? Because of this Sugandh. So Sugandh is the in-house magazine of this Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited, and in 2018-19 it also got this award. That's why I put this award, so put this sentence here. So your responsibility is to know that this magazine belongs to this organization, okay? The CMD of RINL is Atul Bhatt at present. So guys, that was all. If you have liked the session, then do not forget to subscribe our channel as well. Thank you so much for watching the session.